Got a lot of work going on over there. Let's see what's going on. These guys work quick. Oh man, I needed that auger for when I was planting trees. Hello. Hi guys. He's trying to pick a spot to dig the hole.
If you guys didn't see yesterday's video, you gotta go see it to see why that telephone pole is on the ground. There's two companies out here, Choctaw Electric, you know, my electric company that services our power, and then an electric company that has to do the remount my box. My main box is out there for the house. So I'm hoping Choctaw Electric won't charge me because that thing was rotted out at the bottom. It was on its last leg anyway, and actually the tree didn't hit the pole. It was a branch attached to the tree. The tree wasn't on top of the power line, as you guys saw yesterday, but it was still my fault regardless. But it was going to happen, you know, with or without my help. I just kind of made things happen sooner, and I'm glad I was here when it happened. That made it just easier to manage. Anyway, today's checkout day. We gotta get out of here. We have a lot to do. I'm gonna run into town, get a blower for a cleaner so they blow off these porches. Our previous cleaners didn't blow them off, and I realized one of the things is because they got to carry around a blower themselves, so I went ahead and bought one to leave here for them to have access to every time they come out. There goes Broken Bow. We're at home now with more stuff in our trailer than we had when we came. Anyway, we got a long trip. Looks like we're home.
We made it home. We're all still alive.
Thank God for that. That was a long trip.
After that trip.
Why? Because Josie and JoJo?
Josie, the trailer sitting in this back bumpy.
That trailer was throwing us around like crazy.
When I sit back here, I'm reminded of why I want to trade our car in for a minivan. We need a car lower to the ground that's not bumping and humping along.
Bumping and humping. Welcome back to Texas, guys. Feels good to be home. Feels so good. You know, I really miss my trees. I'm not even gonna lie, because I just planted this apple tree. Just wanted to keep an eye on it. Looks good. Still alive. Wanted to eyeball my peach tree, you know? My little baby peach is coming in. Also wanted to see my garden. That's gonna make me cry. See how it's doing out here. How you babies doing? Everybody looking strong and healthy. A blueberry bush right there. Everybody's looking good. Let's see what my seeds are doing. That one. Oh, this was a lettuce head that I planted. Looks like it might do okay. Might do okay. Everybody's looking strong and healthy. Gotta water the top of the soil. Feels pretty dry. It's the benefit of the method I use though, is soil stays moist when I'm away for long periods.
Hi JoJo, I missed you.
I missed her on that car ride. What a baby.
Juliet missed her bike. Abram missed his bike. Looks like we got a limb on the ground. Dang, I'm glad I didn't take out a power line. Sheesh, like it did in Broken Bow.
Guys, look what I'm about to try.
Baby Josie turned 2 months old while we were at the cabin. We're home now, and she has super, super strong neck skills. I kind of think she wants to finish her nap. She woke up from a nap. I had put her in her crib for the first time, and I think it was just not like what she needed or wanted it to be in there. And so, I got to finish up what I was doing in the kitchen. Yes, and I'm going to see if she'll go in her bumbo seat. We'll see.
Let's try it out. Oh my goodness.
Not quite yet. I think we just still have a few more weeks. Not quite yet. What do we think about it, guys? I think she's a little too small.
Definitely still a few weeks to go. Juliet was 3 months when we put her in there. And Abram was like, oh gosh, I don't know. He was probably 3 or 4 months too. I don't even know. I can picture his little body sitting in there, but
he wasn't this tiny, that's for sure.
You want to finish your nap, sissy? You finish your nap? I know. I woke up so early. Oh, Oh goodness, I cannot believe we're home. We're doing bedtime here at home instead of the cabin. I feel like I want to wrap up our time at the cabin.
I miss my things so much, my figs.
You missed your figs? Those are figs, not dates?
Dates, I mean.
Oh, okay.
And I missed my figs too. I'm going to hit those in a minute.
Oh my gosh. So I think I want to ask everybody to wrap up the cabin. What was your favorite part about being at the cabin this time? You have to pick one thing. You can't pick a list of things.
Having movie night with you was cool. We don't have movie night anymore.
Aww.
We had two movie nights.
Mm-hmm.
It was cool.
We watched Steel Magnolias one night, and then we watched the map of Tiny Perfect Things. The tiny map of perfect things.
What's crazy, we saw in Steel Magnolias, the mirror that we have at the cabin and the bathroom is in the movie, the exact same mirror. That's pretty crazy.
That's crazy.
What was your favorite part of the cabin? Was it your bubble bath? She took a big, big bubble bath there. Was that the best part?
Oh yeah,
take
it with me.
Yeah. Your big, big 3-hour nap in mommy's wrap. That was good too. Oh, she's smiling at herself. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. You guys are getting the good stuff. Oh my goodness, your baby. Josie girl.
My favorite part of being at the cabin has got to be the mornings. I said everybody had to pick one thing. Does that count? Like the mornings is my one thing. I just loved the mornings there. They were very peaceful. The baby was super happy because she had just slept her best sleep. And so she would like go to anybody, go to Symphony, go to me. It was just very enjoyable.
I have so many things.
You gotta pick your one favorite thing.
Maybe that new little boy, because I never really meet new kids that often.
Aw, like it kind of felt like meeting a new friend like at school or something.
Mine was doing the doll trade with Kinsey. That was fun.
Oh yeah, Symphony and Kinsey, our neighbor at Broken Bow, did a doll trade for an entire day, and you got her Nana surprise.
Yeah.
And she got your
OMG.
Which OMG was it?
The one that Bebo got me.
What, does she have a name?
Neon.
Neon?
Neonlicious.
Neonlicious. Mm-hmm. We got some major snuggling going on in here. Jules, I need to know, what was the very, very favorite thing that happened at the cabin?
Playing with my Barbies and playing with Kendi and Junior.
That's two things. All right, guys, now it's time to get this girl in her bubble bath here at the house. The house, if I can talk. She seems like she's ready to go to sleep. One other great thing that happened at the cabin for me was rediscovering growth spurts, when they happen, what happens during them. I mean, it's been like 5 years almost since I had a little baby, and 3 years before that. So I feel a little out of practice, and I know that babies go through growth spurts, but I don't like have it down pat like I used to. So rediscovering that, I re-downloaded an app that I've had for, I guess, almost 8 years, because I got the app when I had Abram. It's the Wonder Weeks, and very informative app with having babies and growth spurts and stuff like that. And so it was really helpful. I'm really glad that I went through that and have some new understanding. I'll be sharing it with you guys as I continue to learn. But right now, she's definitely feeling sleepy, and it is a sleepy time. Like, she should technically go to sleep, whether it's for like a late nap, and she tends to go to bed really late at night, like when we do. But she's not falling asleep, so I'm trying to see. I would really like to get her in a bath so that I could get in my room, get it nice and dark, turn the sound machine on, and like put her to bed. But I think she needs a bath before we do all that, because, you know, we're traveling. She didn't take one last night, and I don't give her one every night like I used to, but I try to do it every like 2 to 3 nights, because, you know, her fists get balled up and they get that smell, and, you know, it's just, you know. Anyway, I don't know what I'll say. So I think I'm gonna give her a quick bath, and we will see you guys tomorrow. We have a really, really, really fun day planned tomorrow. We're gonna be out of the house with the whole family doing something we haven't done together in a long time. It's officially like summertime in Texas, so come back tomorrow. We're gonna be out and about, water fun. It's gonna be really fun, so don't miss out. We'll see you there. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe so you can follow along on our growing family and all the fun things we do or don't do. And we'll see you guys tomorrow. Don't forget, he loves you, and remember to love each other.
Looks like our mailbox is kind of full though.
What in the world?